Would God allow human beings as a whole to destroy themselves? Well, as always, let's turn to our Bibles to find out. Stay tuned. In Matthew 24, verses 1 through 28, Jesus shares with the disciples what this entire period between his first coming and his second coming would be like. Let me just give a few of the things that he mentions. He says, for example, there will be international rivalry. There will be wars and rumors of wars. There will be famines. There will be natural disasters. There will be persecution of the church. There will be a great amount of apostasy going on. Now, I'm not going to mention all of them, as I said, but there are a number of things that characterize this entire time period between Christ's first coming, when he came as a baby in Bethlehem, and his second coming, when he returns triumphantly in the end to judge mankind. But in Jesus' speech to the disciples, we find some important insight that helps us answer this question, the question of will mankind destroy ourselves? So look at Matthew 28:22. It says, "And if those days had not been cut short, no human being would be saved. But for the sake of the elect, those days will be cut short." So in context, what is Jesus talking about here? He's talking about this entire period between Christ's first and second coming. In other words, if those days, that is, if this entire period would not be cut short, no one would be saved. That is, no one would survive. But, the text says, for the sake of the elect, those days, this entire period will be cut short, Jesus says. Now, when you see that word elect, that word, it encompasses all of God's redeemed people. So what Jesus is saying here is that if all of these things were permitted to keep on going, wars and international rivalry, false teachers, apostasy, if all of these things were permitted to keep going, there would be no survivors. Mankind truly would destroy ourselves. Now, is that really that surprising? You know, lots of people, believers and unbelievers alike, they recognize the potential for mankind's total annihilation. There are quite a few scientists, for example, that are out there that suggest that climate change is going to end up wiping out humanity. There are also those that suggest that we're going to get into some kind of nuclear war and absolutely destroy ourselves. Some have suggested that AI will be our downfall, kind of like a Terminator doomsday thing that will take place. Others more recently have jumped on the engineered pandemic theory that some lab-engineered virus is going to take all of us out. Now, I don't know if any of these would be the things that take us out. But just think about the evil that is present in this world and think about all the potential there is for destruction. Which is why Jesus says, unless these days are cut short, nobody will survive. So yes, mankind is on track to destroy ourselves, but it's not going to happen because Jesus will spare humans for the sake of his people, for the sake of all of God's redeemed people. Those days, the text says, will be cut short, and there will be a return of Christ to cut them short. Now, this doesn't mean that we can't do a tremendous amount of damage. This doesn't mean that we should just kind of let life go on and not be wise about our living, that we shouldn't live responsibly or vote responsibly or pray responsibly. We should. Just because Jesus says that mankind will be saved from total annihilation doesn't mean we should live how we want and not forget about the consequences or recognize the damages that we've already done. But to conclude, yes, mankind would destroy ourselves somehow. But because of the mercy of God, mankind as a whole will be spared. Physically, that is. Spiritually is another story. And I'll attach a link below to a video where you can learn more about God's plan for mankind spiritually. Thank you so much. God bless you in a way.